So I've been talking about this for months, even made these two videos about it, but now I'm actually starting to learn 3D fashion software, and I'm starting with Browzwear. I've known for a while now that 3D has been important in fashion, and its importance just continues to grow. So I said, all right, I gotta stop faking the funk and go ahead and start learning it. So today's video is trying to coordinate how I start teaching Illustrator and translate that into Browzwear.
So when I start teaching Illustrator, I start with something very simple, usually a t-shirt, and I start with a template. So the first thing I'm going to do is to import an existing pattern. Go to File, Import from Cloud, and I'm going to choose a basic women's t-shirt. Click the image and then hover over it until you see the download button. You'll get an alert to open it in Browzwear once it finishes downloading, and then you'll see the pattern and a model in the vStitcher window. To start, I want to see the model dressed in the t-shirt, so I'll go up to the main toolbar to Snapshots and choose a snapshot. If you need a specific size, small, medium, large, extra large, you can choose the snapshot that corresponds to that size. For this demo, I'm just going to choose a medium, which is probably a sample size for this size range. Now, I have the 2D window with the medium-sized pattern pieces and the 3D window with the sewn garment shown in 3D. If you want to see only one of those windows at a time, move your cursor over the window you want to keep showing and press the Tab key. For instance, if I just want to see the pattern pieces, I can place the cursor anywhere in the 2D window and press the Tab key, and it will close the 3D window and just show the pattern. And to get the 3D window back, just press the Tab key again. I prefer to work with both windows open. Now notice as I move my mouse over each pattern piece in the 2D window, it also highlights that same area of the garment in the 3D window. So as you make changes to the 2D pattern, you can see the updates in real time in the 3D window. You can drag the separator between the two windows to make one or the other wider or skinnier. And to navigate moving up or down, side to side, or zooming in and out, you can use the trackpad using two fingers to slide side to side or up and down, or pinching the trackpad to zoom in or out, much like you do on a smartphone. Now, I'm going to add a simple collar block to the front of this t-shirt, which requires me to cut apart the front body pattern. So first, let's locate the front bodice, and you can easily do this because the pattern piece is labeled. And if you look in the 3D window, you can also see that the front of the t-shirt is highlighted. Next, I'm going to select the pen tool, which works very similarly to the pen tool in Illustrator, and I'm going to draw my new style line. Below the main toolbar is another toolbar that changes depending on what tool you choose, similar to the options or control bars in Photoshop or Illustrator. So before I draw the new line, I'm going to check a few things. The first thing I'm going to do is turn off pieces. This essentially locks the pattern pieces, which I think is helpful, but this is totally optional. The next thing you want to specify is if you want the line to have symmetry or to cross center front. Symmetry is helpful if the line you are drawing needs to be symmetrical. And you only need to draw half, much like you do when you draw a flat sketch in Illustrator and then reflect it. Cross is if you need something to be asymmetrical. And for this demo, I'm going to create an asymmetrical style line on the front. So I'm going to choose cross. I don't need anything snapping to a point or an edge or any of the other options, so I'm going to leave those as is. Next, draw your line with the pen tool and use the pen tool as you would in Illustrator, clicking to make a corner or a straight line and clicking, holding, and dragging to make a curve. Press the Escape key to detach when you've finished creating your line. Next, you need to cut the pattern along the line you just drew to create two separate pattern pieces. From the main toolbar, choose the Select tool and select the new style line you created. To the right, a menu appears with various options for that style line. In the Action section, choose Slice. This will separate the front body pattern into two separate pattern pieces. You'll also notice that in the 3D window, the image now shows a grid. This is how the pattern pieces look when you prepare the mannequin to be dressed. And since we've now changed the pattern pieces a bit, it's showing the new pattern pieces on the mannequin. Now, before she can be redressed properly, you'll need to virtually stitch the two pieces together along the new style seam. You can do this in the 3D or 2D window. For something this simple, I prefer to do it in the 2D window. So first I'm going to separate the two pieces a little so I can see the edge of each piece. Use the Select tool. Make sure you turn pieces back on to unlock them. Click on either new front pattern piece and just drag it away a bit. To virtually sew them together, choose Stitch from the main toolbar and click the edge of the new style line on each front body piece to sew them together. Each line will highlight in the same color as you click on them. Now, click Prepare and then Dress from the main toolbar. And the mannequin should be redressed in the t-shirt. And I usually press Select again to get rid of the stitch lines and to see the garment without any annotations. Now you can see your new style line, but let's have some fun and add some color. So if you look on the left side of the screen, there's some additional panels, 2D, materials, 3D, params. Switch to the materials panel, and this panel shows the fabrics being used on the garment, the stitches, any artwork or trims. And if you scroll to the bottom, there's a color palette. Now you can import your own custom colors, but for now, I'm just gonna use the colors that are there. And to add a color to the garment, drag the color swatch to the pattern piece. And as you do that, you'll also see it recolored in the 3D window.
So I can definitely see this as a fun exercise and a great way for those of you who are new to pattern making to start familiarizing yourself with pattern shapes and creating some new designs from existing patterns. So start with a template to get yourself going and start getting creative. I find that this is the easiest way to learn what the tools can do. Thanks for watching today's video. I know I mentioned that knowing Illustrator is helpful when using these programs, so check out the link in the description to learn more about my online class. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share this video if you found it helpful. Have a fantastic week, and I'll see you next time.